couple weeks ago, we did a video. This is number two for the day, week three. Side hustle Saturday 2019. But this is number two. We're going to trim some bushes up. I already laid the bed sheets out. So I'm not going to explain that to you. Last year, I taught you guys how to do all that. Go back in my library, watch my videos. I teach you guys there. I don't want to keep repeating the lesson. We're now going to put it to use. So now that you know how to do things, or you at least have an idea of how to do it, now you can just watch me do it. And every time you see me doing something, it might be the same thing, but you're going to get something different out of it each time. You're going to be like, oh, okay, because you already see this. So you're not looking at this, now you're looking at this, and you learn, and that's, you know, that's how you learn. But a couple weeks ago, I did a video Q&A about weed eaters and edgers, and I talked about the bump. See, I got this is lined up, and how the bump will wear down, and here's a new insert. So I bought an insert and a spring. It's like $9 at the steel dealership for the insert, and then the spring is separate. And the reason why I like to buy extra springs is because then I don't have to take this spring out and put it in here. But somebody made a really good point in a comment section, and he said the springs get soft and to stretch them out. And look at this. Look how low that spring is in there. And look at this brand new spring is flush. So he's right about that. So you guys are awesome in the comment section. So when you read my comments, you know, don't just watch my videos, but read my comments, because there's some pros that comment that have some really good information that give quick little tips. So, you know, things that I don't really think about. So there you go. So if you have an old spring like this, what he said was take the spring out and just kind of pull it a little bit and then put it back in. All right. And then it'll be nice and strong. But a nice strong spring keeps it more reactive to you. So like this might slowly come out. This, it's going to pop, pop. Nice. It makes it very efficient. But you see the size difference in the head, in the bump? It's a big difference in the bump. And so when you're weed eating along, you can bump it much easier when it's like this. Earlier today, we did a video about the different types of hedge trimmers to use. So please check that video out. I'll link to it up here. For the next these 3 yards that I'm gonna do right now, one on this video and then two on another video, the next video I put up, it's all gonna be done with this hedge trimmer. The long one. All right, and for obvious purposes, you'll see why. See how I keep changing the angle of the head to get a different angle of the cap until I get it nice. where? And that little bit that's left, when I grind the weeds with the weed eater, it'll chop up those little pieces and then just blow it out. But if you had this whole mess sitting on all this cypress mulch that they put down last year out of their own pocket, you'd have a mess. We got some good progress going on with this the Scotts 3-in-1 we put down a couple weeks ago, even though it just recently rained and finally watered it all in. A lot of dead crispy weeds going on here. Grass is getting nice. This is going to be really good. Let's edge here. Line in the spool that I have in my weed eater right now is when I'll put the new insert in, but for now I'll keep using the old insert. 2 3/4 inch height mulch. I sharpened the blades last weekend. I changed the oil too. Let's do it. Looking pretty good now. Like it. Let's go get some lunch.
Tell me about the whistles.